Evaporator out in the primary loop is okay?
That's good, fine.
Okay.
Apollo 8 Houston, over.
Houston, this is Apollo 8 with the TV going, over.
Apollo 8, this is Houston, reading you loud and clear. We see your TV. It's a little bit clear.
Roger, the moon is very bright and not too distinct in this area. I'll give you a shot of the horizon.
Roger.
Is that the right word to use, Econ? Do you want to take the DSC?
Roger, fine.
Apollo 8, this is Houston. It's a good picture of the horizon. We can't see many terrain features as yet.
Roger.
You gonna dump the DSC, Econ?
Not right now. Well, not while we're having TV, but we'd like to get high bit rate.
Apollo 8, Houston. Yeah, we're beginning to pick up a few craters very dimly. The whole thing is pretty bright.
Roger, there's not much definition up here either on the horizon. We're now approaching the craters C and Bassett.
Roger.
That's what you want to say, Econ. He'll understand that. You want to take the DSC.
Roger, fine.
Capcom, Econ wants to take the DSC to get high
rate. Shift to the run of the
window. On the high rate. Let's not say that. Let's take the DSC.
Roger, Bill.
Okay.
Apollo 8, Houston, we want to take the DSC.
Roger, you got it?
Roger. Looks like we got a real good picture now.
Okay, that's the crater brand.
Roger.
Sorry we missed car.
Me too. Apollo 8, this is Houston. We're going to need a cryo fan cycle sometime during this test.
Roger. Can we wait till sunset?
Yeah, wait.
Roger, we can wait.
Okay, I think we're coming up on Miller right now. Very new, bright impact crater. Should be in the field of view now.
Roger, Bill.
Do you see it in the upper part of your screen?
Hey, Bill, how would you describe the color of the moon from here?
The color of the moon looks a very whitish gray, like dirty beach sand, and with lots of footprints in it.
Don't these new craters look like pickaxes striking concrete, leaving a lot of fine haze dust?
There's some interesting features out on the other window. Let me switch windows on you now.
Roger, Bill.
You should see the horizon now in the top of your picture.
Roger, we have the horizon, Bill. Apollo 8,
I believe now these are the craters, Bassett and C.
Roger, Bill, if you have a polarizing filter handy, try flipping it in front, would you?
Roger.
Jerry, as a matter of interest, there's a lot of what appears to be very small new craters that have these little white rays radiating from them.
Roger, Jim. Roger, we see the filter going over. Apollo 8, this is Houston. Looks like we have too much light. The polarizing filter doesn't help much. Go ahead and remove it again.
Roger, it's removed.
Looks like we just got...
Roger, we're passing over the crater Borman. And there's Anders out there. Levels right south of it.
Roger. TV's breaking up now. Okay, we're back with a good picture. Looks like we just have too much light. Our definition is rather weak.
Roger. Fogged up the window here,
Houston,
is one of the other props.
Roger, Bill, the other window was better than this one.
Okay.
Yeah, much better picture, Bill, much better.
All right, the right side of the camera is pointing retrograde. We are now passing a beam of the crater Houston. And I'll shine the camera over there once for the folks in Texas.
Roger.
It's a big and sprawly one. It's got those two impact craters, one to the right and one to the left.
Roger, Bill. Still about the same, Bill. It's the terrain's pretty bright. We're not getting much definition at all. Definition on this side is much, much better.
Okay, I think. Okay, we'll leave it here. The wind, that gives you an idea how bad our window is.
Roger, this picture now is much better. I guess the light levels are decreasing now.
Okay, we're coming up on the crater Collins.
Roger, what crater is that that's just going off?
That's some small impact crater.
Roger.
We'll call it John Aaron's.
Okay.
If he'll keep looking at the systems anyway.
He just quit looking.
Craters have dark spots in the center where it appears that the buried head and hit some new material down below that's got a lot of fine white dust around them.
Roger, understand, yeah. This is Houston, Apollo 8, this is Houston. Looks like we can see Collins now.
Roger, there's Collins for you.
And Collins is right on the edge of Spice C, which we're about to pass over.
Roger.
Looking there, Gene C.
Apollo 8, this
is Spice C.
Power's still well above
the line.
Roger, we just saw a Stellan work go by.
More than you expect.
Pardon? He is using, but it is not excessive.
Roger.
Ecom, how you doing?
He was really in a hurry.
Roger. Picture is much improved now. Getting better all the time.
Roger. The terrain here is, as you can see, not well defined. We're going to start a roll to the left. In order to come across the target area with the television.
Roger.
Landing site area.
Roger, Bill.
Now.
Roger, that's a very good one. That must be O'Neill. Roger, Bill. We see O'Neill real well, also the smaller crater off to the side of it.
That's Dennis.
Roger.
Houston, this is Apollo 8. We're going to terminate our program for this pass and get on with preparations for LOI 2. If you say we're go.
Apollo 8, this is Houston. Roger.
Okay, signing off until a ninth rev, Apollo 8.
Apollo 8, Houston. Roger.
Thank him for the look, Jerry.
Apollo 8 Houston, Roger, thank you for the look.